Hello and welcome all of you. Hope that everyone are safe at their home and enjoying learning. What I think, whatever we are doing, any work like learning something new, etc., we all must do it with the full dedication and enjoyment. The enjoyment is important. Keep trying new things. Don't be the kind of that student who just stuck to his syllabus. But what I think, try something new beyond your syllabus. You know, you should explore yourself. Make your learning as an adventure and take the challenges and prove that challenges as your opportunity. That's what a actual life I think that every student should do. Well, just I share with you some thought. Now moving towards the topic of the today's video. You may heard about the endo and the exo-isomerism. We came across it many times. You know that endo and the exo-isomerism is a special type of the stereoisomerism which is found in the organic compound. Having the substitution at a on a bridge ring system, these isomerisms are found generally in the in such kind of the organic compound. You may also heard about the Diels-Alder reaction in which we get the endo and the exo as a product. We know that after synthesizing or forming any product of the reaction, the question arises, what's the stereochemistry of the product, correct? In the case of the double bond, the substitution are either cis or a trans. Same like that, the endo and the exo-isomerism are to determine the stereochemistry for a bicyclic compound. Generally, the orientation is endo means it is a trans and exo means cis. Okay, many of students found it difficult to distinguish between the endo and the exo-isomer. So I will tell you how to distinguish it by knowing just some concept over here. So knowing about the general bicyclic compound. This is a general bicyclic compound. This is a bridge carbon atom. This is a cavity. This is a concave side of the bicyclic compound and this is a cavity on the concave side. Actually, the substituent attached to this bicyclic compound determine which isomer is an endo-isomer and which is an exo-isomer. So now let us learn about which isomer is an endo and which isomer is an exo. Now learning about the endo and the exo identification. As I already told you, this is a general bicyclic compound. This is a bridge carbon atom of the bicyclic ring. This is a concave side of the bicyclic ring. This is a cavity of the concave side. Now firstly, learning about the identification of the endo isomer. See here, the substituent are attached to this bicyclic ring. If the substituents are pointing towards the cavity, okay, the substituent is pointing towards the cavity and the bridge carbon atom and the substituent are trans to each other. See, these both are trans to each other, so the orientation is endo. Nextly, identifying the exo-isomer. Here, if the substituent which is attached is cis to the bridge carbon atom and it is pointing away from the cavity. See, this is a cavity, this is pointing away from the cavity and these are cis to each other. So, the isomer is the exo-isomer. This is how we differentiate the endo and the exo-isomer. Here, you can summarize as if the substituent are trans to each other, then the isomer is an endo-isomer. If the substituent which is attached are cis to the bridge carbon atom, that means they are in the cis orientation, then it is the exo-isomer. Generally, we call endo as a trans and exo as a cis. Okay, now we will clear it by seeing some example further. See, this is an endo. Why this is endo over here? Because these are the substituent and the bridge carbon atom are trans to each other. And here the substituent and bridge carbon atom are cis to each other. So it is an exo-isomer. Okay. Now we will see more example to for the identification of the endo and the exo-isomer. Here the first example you can see. This is an exo-isomer. Why it is exo? Because the substituent which are attached over here are cis to each other. See, this OH and this are cis to each other and this is pointing away from the cavity. So, this is an exo-isomer and here this is an endo. Why this is endo? Because the substituent is trans to The bridge carbon. This is a bridge carbon atom. This is a substituent. They are trans to each other, and this is pointing towards the cavity. So this is an endo isomer. Same like that. This is an example of the Diels-Alder reaction. This is an endo product. Why this is endo product? Because they are trans to the bridge carbon atom, and they are cis to the bridge carbon atom. So they are exo. Same like that. This is also example of the Diels-Alder reaction. Here, this is endo. Why this is endo? Because they are in a trans orientation to the bridge. Here bridge oxygen is there, so they are trans in orientation. So this is the endo product, and this is an exo product over, because they are in the cis orientation with each other. Okay, then again, this is an endo product, this is an exo product. Why they are endo product? Because the substituent are trans to the bridge carbon, and here they are cis to the bridge carbon. That is, they are in the same plane, they are in the opposite plane. Same like this example, here it is an exo product. Why? Because they are cis to each other, and this is an endo product. Why? Because they are trans to each other. This is how we differentiate between the endo and the exo isomer. Hope you all like the content which I share with you and happy with knowing how to distinguish between the endo and the exo isomerism. If you really like the content which I share with you, so please like, share and subscribe my channel for further update. Thank you for listening this video.